everyone, and welcome to another episode of Mastering Maize and Blue. On today's episode, myself, Ava Abramowicz, and my other OL here, Joseph Scannell, will be talking about resources for deciding a major. So if you're a student who doesn't know what exactly they want to do with their life or what direction they want to take their career, we're here to help you look at the resources that the campus has to offer for determining what you exactly want to do with your life. So as I said, I'm Ava Abramowicz, and I recently was an undecided student. For my entire freshman year, I had no idea what I wanted to do. Recently, as in yesterday, I declared my major as journalism and screen studies and professional writing and rhetoric. So I'm double majoring, but it took me a long while to determine what exactly I wanted to do, and that's totally okay. And I'm here to help you determine like maybe what you want to do and some resources that I used, because it can definitely be quite the process. I am also involved on campus despite it being online this past year. I am in Phi Sigma Sigma. I am also in the Honors Program and Lyceum, our student journal. And a fun fact about me is my favorite candy is white chocolate Reese's.
All right, so I'll introduce myself. My name is Joseph Scannell. My major is in finance, and my involvement is in the Supply Chain Association. I was thinking about doing supply chain as a minor or like concentration with my finance. So that's why you'll see the different finance and supply chain. One fun fact about me, my favorite food is popcorn. I don't care if it's air pop, microwave pop, and anything pop. Love popcorn for sure. So yeah, that's my fun fact. So Lynda, if you would like to introduce yourself.
Sure. Yes. I didn't realize I was going to have a slide, but hi, my name is Lynda Dioszegi, and I'm the assistant director and senior advisor in the START office. And I work with the undecided population. I have been on campus advising for the past 24 years. I came from the College of Business. So Joseph, I am familiar with what you're majoring in and your association, your affiliation with the Supply Chain Association, but I've worked in the START office since START started in the fall of 2016. So I transitioned from working with business students to working with Kessel Undecided students.
To kick things off, we're just going to ask some general questions about campus to our guest Lynda here. So what is your favorite part about U of M Dearborn?
I would say that because I've been at U of M Dearborn for so long, what I think is my favorite part is working with students. Obviously, I need to have students in order to do my job, but I think the collegiality among students and the familiarity that they have with the campus and their level of involvement, and that they, for the most part, take advantage of the different resources and the opportunities to get involved on campus. They're very engaged, which I really appreciate. So the students is probably my favorite part about the campus, about U of M Dearborn.
I definitely agree with how students are engaged and involved. Even though this past year has been online, I still felt, you know, pretty involved on campus through, you know, Zoom meetings and different, you know, opportunities on campus. I was able to join clubs. I know a lot of students were able to. And although there were some struggles this year, obviously, I still feel like there was a sense of campus community. So I also really appreciate that about campus. Joseph, do you have anything to say?
I met some of the students here and around campus and stuff. And during when we were doing our orientations, and I'm excited for a lot of the new freshmen as well. You know, they seem like very down to earth people and very just, very excited to just kick off what they want to do and how they want to progress for their career. So yeah, definitely as students. So this is my question. So how would you describe campus and as well as the community around it?
I would say that it's like a big family, and that may sound a little cliche, but I appreciate that we are big enough that you feel like you're still getting that university experience, but at the same time, having that familiarity with not only the students that like I get to meet through, for instance, orientation, working with the orientation leaders, but then also working with my colleagues across campus and having that familiarity of knowing who to go to when I need a question answered or if I know who to refer a student to. I really appreciate that. And that's not something I think you'll find on bigger campuses, for instance, in Ann Arbor, because they're so big. I think it would be really difficult to have that same type of familiarity and collegiality with the staff and the faculty and the students.
No, yeah, I definitely agree. You know, part of the reason, you know, I decided to come here was because, you know, that big fish in a small pond kind of feeling. And, you know, I definitely agree with the point that you made about how it's not too small and it's not too big. It's kind of just right. And that you still have things that you're able to do. And I would just like to shout out the staff here, because the staff I've met so far, like they really work for the kids and they really are there to help, you know. You know, just to help kids get through college. And yeah, so, and I think for the community, you know, like students, there's enough for people to be involved and to do things. And, you know, even like the community outside of campus, I mean, there's great food around here. So I'm definitely excited when I come back to campus that, you know, I can stop by and, get recommendations for, you know, restaurants to go to and just kind of feel everything out. And yeah, it's definitely exciting. So yeah.
Yeah, I agree with that. I think the community is definitely like a family. Dearborn is mostly a commuter school, but there is still that like family feel. There are a ton of opportunities to get involved. And I really appreciate the smaller class sizes because I've personally been able to reach out to my professors and create like, you know, bonds with them. And that can really help you, especially in the professional world where, you know, I have friends at Ann Arbor per se, and, you know, they have 120 students in their class. They don't know their professors all that well. So that really appealed to me about Dearborn when I was looking where to go for college. Our next question for Lynda is, what are some of your main responsibilities?
So I am partially advisor, but also partially an administrator. So my predominant responsibility is to do academic advising. So working with the undecided population. But then I also supervise three professional staff. So three of the advisors in START. I supervise as well as the student staff. So the front desk staff that we have for the office, which is currently three student staff, I also supervise. And then I do some behind the scenes stuff. So I do I help to facilitate we have a Canvas page that we roll out for freshmen every year. So I do the updates on that. I do budget reconciliation for our office. I work with different offices on different initiatives for first year students. So kind of do a little bit of everything, but predominantly it's going to be that advising piece that I do.
Yep, and advising is so important for first year students, especially if you're undecided. Personally, last year when I was a first year and I was undecided, I needed all the help I could get for determining my major. So advising really helped me, like even just talk out loud about what I like, what I don't like, and really helped me make a decision about what was the best career path for me. So definitely appreciate the advising office. If you're watching this and you're a first year student, or even if you're not, if you're still a student, every semester make sure you're like, in touch with the advising office, you're on track for your career goals. They can help a lot.
I agree. Yeah, we work with advisors, and definitely want to reach out to your advisor. So, what is your favorite part about your job?
I would say that one of the favorite parts about my job, and I feel like this is a little bit of a duplicate answer from the first question, but is working with those students and helping them make that decision when I see that they have that aha moment and they're like, oh, yeah, I totally get it. And not that I need to be appreciated for my job, but it's nice when a student comes back and says to me, thank you. I really appreciate how you helped me, or you referred me to that resource. And I don't want to say that I need to hear that I couldn't have done it without you, but it's nice to be recognized that I was able to help a student. Ava, when I saw your change of major come through, I was like, yay, she made a decision. So I just like to be able to help students. Make that decision, or at least point them to the resources to help them make that decision. So when they are able to come to that decision and they feel good about it, that's one of like the biggest thank yous that I can get for what I do.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure there's a lot of good feelings that come out of, I'm definitely sure about that. When you really, when you help out a student, really find what they are passionate about, so.
Yeah, I mean, I personally know that I could not have done it without the advising office, especially like your help, very much appreciated. I had about seven different majors I was looking at going into my freshman year. So if I didn't have somebody to like help guide me and like know, help me look at what I really want to do and career paths, because I have no idea about any of that. If I didn't have someone there, like I would probably still be undecided. So I definitely appreciate the help. So for our next question, we're going to start diving a little bit more into specific questions for resources on determining a major and how students can actually take action and go about it. So our first question is, how should students go about scheduling appointments for guidance with picking a major?
So, for the students that are undecided, they would be working directly with me. And we have required advising in the start office, as you may or may not know. But when students are really working towards picking that major, they'll start by scheduling an appointment with me, which they can do through contacting the start front desk, either by calling or by emailing. And then we'll usually have a conversation and start talking about interests, passions, maybe courses that students have taken that they really enjoy. And then I typically may refer a student to career services, and there's some career assessments that students can do that might be one of the future questions. But and then I work directly with Jen McLeod in the Career Services office, who works with the undecided population as well. So she does, I do the advising part of it, and she'll do the career services part of it. Maybe having students do the career assessment, and then she'll talk to students about that assessment and then furthering the conversation about, based on the assessment, what direction they can go for majors and then potentially the careers that they can pursue with those different majors. So it's usually like a multi-layered process when we start having those conversations.
Yep, I definitely agree. The Office of Career Services and advising definitely go hand in hand. Obviously, super related to each other. Your majors are going to determine your career. So we do have questions about the career services later on in this presentation. So we'll definitely get to that. Great resource.
So I know there's some online resources that can be used on the website, on the U of M Dearborn website. So I'd like to say the question, what online resources can students use for deciding a major?
So there is the career assessment that I mentioned through Career Services, which is called Focus to Career. And you can find that on the Career Services landing page. And that's usually the, I don't want to say the only resource that I refer students to, but it's the top at the top of the list. And then there are some different resources. This may sound a little corny, but I always tell students to Google. So I've met with students and I've done a screen share and I'll just Google, like, you know, when they say, I've had some students that are like, I want to go into x-ray technology or sonography, or I want to be a nutritionist. And so sometimes it's like, okay, so let's look at this together. So I will do like a Google search. There's also a website literally called What Can I Do With This Major? And so I've used that also in the past, and it gives literally a list of different majors, and then you click on it and it has a PDF that will give you like a list of for the different majors, the different careers that students can pursue. So that's one I used like when I first started advising undecided students. So also a really good resource. So
yeah, the internet is the ultimate resource. So and there's
absolutely,
yeah. And I was an undecided person, but you know, I mean, I'm sure there's definitely like a lot of researching, you know, that comes with it. So
yeah. I feel like Google is like the most overlooked basic resource that like everybody like pretty much has access to. If you don't have a computer, you know, there are like computers on campus, library that you can definitely use, but just Googling, you know, for example, myself, I want to be a journalist. I Google so much about journalism. I looked into all the facts. Google's just honestly a great resource. Our next question is, in what ways can the Office of Career Services help students explore options for their major?
So I know I kind of covered this like two questions ago, but as I mentioned before, Jen McLeod will run we call it a campaign. So she'll send an email to all the undecided students that she has availability to meet with students who are undecided to talk about majors and career options. So she would be the person that I would refer students to directly. And then again, looking at the resources that Career Services has available on their website, namely those career assessments that then again, Jen or another career services counselor can go over the results of those assessments with the student. So, and they also are really good for, finding internships or co-ops. I know each school has their own kind of point person for that as well. But when you're kind of starting out at the kind of the top level, you know, before you start delving in, that they can refer students to those different opportunities as well.
Yeah, career services is a great resource for any student who doesn't really know what they want to go into, but even for students who have an intended major, definitely check out the Office of Career Services. The career assessment is a great resource to take. I personally took it. I learned a lot about myself and maybe what I should go into. And even online, besides Dearborn, there are other career assessments you can take that I also personally took off campus. So any type of career assessment is just a really good reflection tool.
So, are there any misconceptions about undecided majors that you would like to address or clarify? Maybe thinking like how much time you should take before you pick a major, or maybe the office itself.
I think one of the misconceptions for undecided students is that they have no direction. And I have to say that oftentimes, students who are undecided aren't really undecided, but the kind of the feature or the nice thing about being an undecided student is it actually gives you time to try out courses. And make that decision as you're taking those courses. Because in programs like business, for instance, or engineering, if you come in as a declared major in either of those areas, you have to take the prescribed courses. And it doesn't give you a lot of flexibility to kind of play around with your schedule and try courses out to see if that's really the direction that you want to go, because they're monitoring what you're taking and making sure that you're following the program, so to speak, so that you're taking the courses that are required by that specific program. So generally, most of the undecided students that I'm working with aren't really undecided. They're more deciding than undecided. So I think that's one of the bigger misconceptions. And as a parent of two college-age students, I think I have a little bit more leniency with my own children, as they're figuring things out, because I know what it's like to work with students who are undecided. And I don't even like to say undecided, but I like to say more exploring or deciding than undecided.
Yeah, I agree. But people that I know, some students that are like decided, they think they're decided, and then as they fill out and then as they take courses, they'll be like, I don't necessarily like this and it's not my forte, and they'll switch. So I mean you can't really just label like some like students that they're deciding. Yeah, definitely agree. So
Yeah,
yeah,
agreed.
you're exactly right, Joe. I think, even I'll use you as an example. You came in as a pre-business student and you made a decision on that direction. But I've had many a business student or an engineering student or education student who has switched to undecided because they weren't necessarily sure that was the direction that they wanted to go. Maybe it just sounded good on paper, or maybe it's because that's what their parents said they should do. And then they, like you said, maybe it's taken a class or two, and then like, yeah, not so much. So they've made the switch to undecided to buy them some time before they can fully invest themselves in a direction.
Yeah, I agree with the no direction thing. I was undecided, but I had so many different interests, just so many things that I could make into a career that I really liked all over the board. I didn't feel directionless. I just figured like, wow, I have so many different interests. Like, I don't know how to pick one. So that was my problem. And I know a lot of undecided students feel that same way. They have like maybe one, like two, three, or more just different interests. And they're like, all right, which one do I like the best? Like, trying to figure out which one do I make into my actual career. So yeah, that's a very big misconception. Is there any additional information you think students should know about undecided majors or resources for declaring a major?
Not really. I mean, other than what I've talked about, I think one of the nice features to the office that I work in the START office, is that students have accessibility to all the advisors for the four different academic units in one place. So it's not unheard of if I'm meeting with a student and they say to me, hey, I'm thinking about engineering, I can literally walk them down the hall to meet with an engineering advisor to see what that might look like for them, or education, or any of the other academic units. So, you know, definitely utilizing advising, definitely utilizing career services, definitely talking to faculty in disciplines in the areas that you're interested in. I don't think that students utilize faculty as much as they could or should. So that's another resource that students have available that I don't think that they utilize to the full potential. So those would be, you know, the people that you really want to be talking to.
Yeah, one other thing I would like to know, and I don't know if you have anything to comment on it or would like to explain it more, but is the 60 credits when you declare a major. So I know that once you reach 60 credits, you have to declare a major. And correct me if I'm wrong, otherwise you're placed on academic hold, I believe.
Yeah, thank you for bringing that up, Ava. No, you're right. Students have to declare a major by the time they reach 60 credits. And if they don't declare a major, they will be placed on a registration hold. So, you know, I usually start having the conversations with students when they're right around like 45 credits, because the way that it works is if you come in as an undecided major and you will stay in START advising until you declare a major. So you're hanging out with me for that time until you do declare something. So usually right around the 45-ish credit mark, I'm, you know, starting to tell students, okay, you know, we need to start having more serious conversations about majors or what your major might look like. There was something else I was going to say, but yeah, I lost my train of thought. But yeah, so yes, for sure by 60 credits, students will have to declare something. Typically, students are making a decision by then. Sometimes they're waiting on like improvement of GPA or having to complete certain classes in order to make the transition into the major that they want. So there might be a lag in being able to declare prior to the 60 credits, but I'm usually working with those students up until that point.
So you might have maybe repeated, but this earlier, but what advice would you give to a new U of M Dearborn student?
Just in general, what advice would I have? I would really encourage students to get involved. I think that's really important, and that really can enhance your experience at U of M Dearborn. Again, I know you both mentioned that there's lots of opportunities to get involved. There's 160 student groups that students can participate in. There's student government, there's SAB, Lyceum, like you, Ava. So there's all kinds of things that students can participate in to really hone their interests. And it's not only good for that, it's good for networking. It looks great on a resume. So, but I'm all about the experience and what type of experience you're able to have while you're a student. Because you only get one shot at this, you know, college student experience. So why not make the most of it while you can? So that would probably be my biggest piece of advice.
I agree. You know, for me, once I started getting involved, you know, it's kind of, our first year was virtual, and you know, and I didn't necessarily feel out the college experience at first, and then once more I got involved, you know, I felt my motivation to, you know, do good in school and stuff, you know, went up, and as well, you know, just, you know, more happy and stuff, you know, being excited about coming back to campus. And use Victor's link for involvement for supply chain association that I'm in. That's what I use to find that out and find information about joining that. So, yeah.
Yeah, I agree. I personally live my life by just saying like yes and going for it. So I'm all for getting involved. I'm all for taking opportunities. You do only typically do college, you know, once. You may go back, but like this is like your prime time to take all these opportunities, travel abroad, be in clubs, really like explore your interests, meet new people. So I fully encourage getting involved. I am all for it. And we actually will be having some Mastering Maize and Blue podcast series later on in the summer about different opportunities for getting involved. Personally, I'm doing another one on Greek life and on the Wolverine Media Network, which Lyceum is a part of. So stay tuned for those.
And to be comfortable, you must be uncomfortable. So always try new experiences. That's what I always tell myself. So, yeah. So,
what fun facts would you like to share about yourself?
I don't know. What do you want to know? I mean, I already mentioned I've been at U of M Dearborn for a really long time. I lived abroad for just under a year with my husband. We lived in Germany, so that's kind of a fun fact. So I'm all about study abroad if you have the opportunity and can put yourself out of your comfort zone to study in another country. I am also an alumni member of a sorority from Eastern Michigan, and I currently serve on their advisory board. I am a Delta Zeta. I'm in a graduate program right now, so I'm slowly but surely working through an online graduate program, so I know all about taking classes online. I just finished a class summer one, and I just have I'm just over halfway through, so hopefully we'll graduate from my graduate program in winter of 2023. So I have an end date in mind here, but my I have two kids. My son is going into his senior year at Western Michigan, and my daughter will start her freshman year at Siena Heights University in Adrian, and she will be playing softball there. So we're excited to watch her continue to play softball. I've been married for 27 years to my husband, Tim. And yeah, so, and I've been working from home since March of 2020. And I'm looking forward to being back on campus and seeing everybody in person, so.
Yeah, I think that's really cool that you lived abroad. I'm into travel. I have actually considered starting a travel club or something at Dearborn. Got it kind of in the works a little bit, but I'm all for travel, studying abroad, living in new places. So I think it's really awesome that you lived in Germany.
Yeah, it was a really great experience. So, and I wasn't a college student, so it was a little bit different experience, but it was fun nonetheless.
I have to ask real quick. I heard your dog earlier. I have a dog. I love dogs. What type of dog do you have?
She is a Maltese Chihuahua mix. And we had adopted her, not as a puppy, but she was two. So she's been with us for seven years. So, and she runs the house. So,
yeah, a black Labrador myself. It's called Scout. So, love her to death. So anyway, this is contact information for Lynda if you guys want to reach out, and as well as start advising, and the link to the website is right there below. So
yeah, and just to wrap up, We encourage you to check out the other episodes of Mastering Maize and Blue that are already up and the ones coming throughout the summer. A great resource to start off your freshman year. You don't want to miss out on information and possible opportunities on campus. You can also visit that website to like see the list of episodes we have up. But yeah, thank you so much, Lynda, for being with us today. Appreciate your advice and your help with this episode.
Thank you.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate you guys.
Yeah.